Hello everyone. So last time we have done packing efficiency, and before that we have done packing in solids. So once the packing is done, you know that every time it won't be 100% perfect. The packing won't be 100% perfect. So there leads to some defects or the imperfection in the crystal. Okay, so today we'll be learning defects and its imperfection in detail. Okay, so let's begin. Now, what do you mean by these defects and imperfections? Now, whatever the irregularities, like we have like a set of packing, we have decided like this should be cation and anion ratio and it should be maintained. If there are any irregularities in forming a crystal lattice, that means the basis and the lattice, you know now, if the lattice point is like, for example, if it has to be Na and Cl, and if there is the position of Na and Cl is changed, then we can say that there is a defect in the crystal. So if there is irregularities in the arrangement of constituent particles of a solid crystal, then we call it as defects or imperfection. Anything, like anything, if you have to arrange, for example, alphabets A, B, C, D, instead of that thing, I just arrange in a different manner, or one alphabet is missing, then that is nothing but called as defects. Okay, that is just an example I have taken. Similarly, even in solids, whatever the constant particles it is made up of, if the arrangement of that particle is changed as compared to the ideal one, then we can say that they are nothing but defects, or any extra impurities added, that is also called as what, a foreign particle is introduced in a crystal, then also we can say that that is nothing but a defect or imperfection in the crystal. Okay, so till here hopefully it is understood nicely what do you mean by defects and imperfections. Okay, fine. Now normally this is created while the process of crystallization. Okay, normally it is created during the process of what? Crystallization. Now what do you mean by that? Now when we talk about the process of crystallization, the crystals are formed when the crystallization occurs in a slow rate. Okay, if the time taken to form a crystal is very very slow, then we can say that perfect crystals are made. But as a result, we don't have time to wait for the formation of a crystal sometimes. So there we directly keep it in ice water so that the crystals are formed very fast. So as a result, what will happen? The formation of the crystals are not up to the mark. Okay. So that is what, if slower the process of crystallization, more proper will be the crystal formed. Okay. So first important thing is the crystals, the defects are created during the process of crystallization. Now, ideal crystals, there is nothing called as ideal. Ideal crystals are possible only at absolute zero temperature. Now, what do you mean by absolute zero? Nothing but zero Kelvin. Okay, so at that temperature, it is not possible easily. So, ideal crystals as such is not there. Okay, now above this temperature, they contain defects. That means if it is not zero Kelvin, we can say that they actually contain some or the other defects. Okay, now, but even though they are having defects, the electrical neutrality is maintained in the crystal. Now what do you mean by electrical neutrality there? That means, like for example, cations and anions are there, the charges are maintained. If one cation is missing, then anion will be also missing, so that as a result, the charge will be maintained in the crystal. Okay, the solid will be as a result nothing but what? Neutral in charge. Okay, now sometimes for our purpose, we create defects in the crystalline solids. Like we have to make some or the other solid with having some properties, then we actually what, create defects in a crystal. Now for example, simple example is alloys. When you want to form alloys, we add some impurity in that thing. Okay, so that is nothing but defects we are creating. Okay, so that is one example of defects where it is useful. Okay, so hopefully till here it is understood what is defects. Okay, now defects are of three types. We'll learn the classification of defects first. Okay, now these are the classification of defects. We'll be mainly focusing on point defect. We'll be mainly focusing on which one? Point defect. Okay, now defects are of three types. What are they? Point defect, line defect, and plane defect. Okay, if the defect is only in a particular lattice point, then it is said to be what? Point defect. If it is across one whole line, that is one whole row, then we can call it as what? Line defect. And if it is across one whole plane, then we call it as what? Plane defect. Here in this chapter, we'll be learning more about point defect. Okay. Now, talking about point defect, there are three types: stoichiometric defect, impurity defect, non-stoichiometric defect. We'll be learning each one in detail over here. Okay, so the first one, stoichiometric defect, they are again classified as vacancy defect, self-interstitial defect, Schottky defect, and Frenkel defect. Okay, now the second one, this is nothing but impurity defect. Impurity defect is again classified as what? Substitutional defect and interstitial defect. Now the last one, non-stoichiometric defect. Non-stoichiometric defect is classified as metal deficiency defect and metal excess defect. Okay, so we are going to do the classification of point defect and we are going to learn each one in detail. Okay, fine. So let's start with point defect now. Now, what is point defect? As I told you before, if the irregularities are seen in the bases at lattice points in crystal solids, then it is called as point defect. We know what is, like for example, if this is a lattice, lattice plus bases forms a what? Lattice plus bases forms a crystal structure. That means at a particular lattice, the constant particle is nothing but our basis. If that is missing or it has changed its position, then we call it as what? Point defect. Okay, so now point defects are classified into three types. Okay, so first we are going to see the first type in detail, that is nothing but stoichiometric point defect. Okay, now what do you mean by stoichiometric point defect? Stoichiometric point defect is nothing but when the ratio of a compound, we are talking mainly of the ratio of the compound over there. Okay, but even after missing, the stoichiometry remains the same in the crystal. Okay, like for example, any of the chemical formula, NaCl is there. Okay, now it will be having fixed ratio. They will be having what? A fixed ratio will be having. Okay, even though if one Na is taken out, one Cl will be also taken out, so that the chemical formula will always and always remain same. So stoichiometric means fixed ratio is maintained in the point defect. Okay, so fixed ratio stoichiometry of the compound is maintained. Stoichiometry remains what? Unchanged in the crystal structure. Okay, then we call it as what? Stoichiometric point defect. Okay, now the stoichiometric point defects are of four types. Okay, so each one we will see in detail. Now to start with first one, vacancy defect. Okay, so to start with vacancy defect, now as the name suggests, vacancy means there will be some empty space in the crystal. There will be some empty space in the crystal. Okay, so can you see a crystal? It is formed of some of the particles, they constant particles. Now this place and this place, it is vacant. That means vacancy is created in the crystal. Okay, so this leads to a vacancy defect when the particle is missing from its lattice point. Okay, so this thing is nothing but vacancy created. This is nothing but vacancy created. Now as a result, what will happen? The mass of the crystal will decrease. The mass of the crystal will decrease because the number of constant particle in the crystal structure is decreased. As a result, what will happen? The mass will decrease. but the volume remains unchanged over here. Therefore, we can say that density will also decrease over here. Why the density decreases? We know that density is nothing but equal to mass upon volume. Now, density and mass are directly related to each other. So, therefore, we can say that if the mass decreases, density will also decrease in this case. Okay? So, hopefully till here it is understood nicely. And this occurs either during crystallization or when the crystal is heated up. These are the two conditions when vacancy defects are seen. Okay, so now we'll move on with this next one. Next one is self-interstitial defect. Next one is what? Self-interstitial defects over here. Now, to understand self-interstitial defect, first we have to understand what do you mean by interstitial sites. Okay. Now, what are interstitial sites? They are nothing but the spaces or voids. That means whatever the spaces are left after the formation of crystal structure, they are said to be interstitial sites. They are said to be what? Interstitial sites. So, we can define it as what? Interstitial sites in a crystal are the spaces or voids in between the particles at lattice points. So, hopefully just remember, interstitial sites are nothing but the spaces or voids in a crystal. Okay, fine. So, to understand more about self-interstitial defect, we have to first define what do you mean by self-interstitial defect. Now, as the name suggests, if some of the particles in a crystalline element, if it occupies the interstitial position, then we call it as what? Self-interstitial defect. Simple. As the name suggests, if the particle occupies what? Interstitial sites, we refer it as what? Self-interstitial defect. Okay, please understand, vacancy and self-interstitial defect, we cannot give an example of ionic compounds. Okay, just remember that. Okay, now this self-interstitial defect are of two ways. This self-interstitial defects are of two ways. Now, what are they? I've drawn the same crystal structure over here. Okay, now we'll understand what happens when there is a defect created. Okay, so the firstly what will happen is, same particle, if it is added in the crystal, okay, if there are same particle added in a crystal, in which what will happen, they will occupy the interstitial sites, then it is referred to as this crystal. In this thing, what will happen? The density will increase. The density will increase because the number of constituent particle in the crystal has increased over here. Okay, but please understand, whatever be the particle which is added, it will be same over here. Okay, if it is made of copper will be added extra. Okay, copper is added extra. It will be same element or same compound, whatever. Okay, fine. Here, as a result, what will happen? The density increases. Why the density increases? Because the mass increases in a crystal, mass increases and the volume remains same. As a result, what will happen? The density will also increase. I hope you know the relation now between density and mass. Okay, now second case, again I have taken a perfect crystal. Okay, now here what will happen is, one of the constituent particle from its original site will occupy any of the interstitial site. Okay, then what happens in the original site, what is created? Vacancy is created and this occupies the interstitial site. Okay. Hopefully till here it is understood nicely. Okay. Now, if you want to comment on the density over here, the density will remain unchanged because we haven't added anything extra and we haven't taken out anything from the crystal. Therefore, here we can say that the density remains unchanged. Okay. So hopefully, and we can say that this is an example of the combination of vacancy and interstitial defect. Okay, fine. Hopefully till here it is cleared. Once again, vacancy defect, we will see vacancy in the crystal, there the density decreases. Interstitial thing, they are in two ways. One, where we are when the constituent particles are extra in a crystal and that occupies the interstitial side and which leads to increase in the density, that is a one way. Second is when the number of particles in the crystal remain same, only thing is that it will from one of the position it will go and occupy the interstitial position. As a result, vacancy is created as well as that particular particle will be occupying the interstitial site. Then we call it as what? Self-interstitial defect. But this will be the combination of vacancy as well as interstitial defect. And here the density will remain unchanged. Okay. So hopefully till here it is understood. Next, we will be seeing the third type is, understand, we are talking about what? Point defects over here. Under that thing, we are learning stoichiometric defect over here. We are actually learning about stoichiometric defect over here. The stoichiometry will remain same. Okay, fine. Now, the next one, Schottky defect. Okay, to talk about Schottky defect, please understand, always remember VS. Okay, to understand Schottky defect, always remember VS. What is VS? It is nothing but vacancy is there. Now, when we talk about the other two, that is what? Schottky defect and Frenkel defect. These two, Schottky defect and Frenkel defect, they are particularly seen in ionic compounds. They are particularly seen in ionic compounds. Okay, so we will be learning that into detail now. Now, to talk about Schottky defect, I have drawn a crystal over here, crystal structure over here. It is said that vacancy, just to understand, we have done VS. So Schottky refers to vacancy. Okay, now here what is missing? Equal number of cations and anions are missing. Equal number of cations and anions are missing. Okay, that means from any of the position in this thing, I can say that one cation is missing and one anion is missing. Okay, so I can write it as here there will be what? We can say that this is plus means cation. So here there is cationic vacancy and here there will be anionic vacancy. Okay, so hopefully till here it is understood. In Schottky defect, equal number of cation and anion is missing. Now it is one pair. Okay, I can do one more. I can just take out this positive, but if I am taking one positive species out, I have to take one negative species out. Then only the electrical neutrality is maintained in the crystal. Please understand, we have to maintain the electrical neutrality. That is why it is referred to as equal number of cations and anions are missing in the crystal. Okay. Now, this paired cation anion vacancy defect is said to be what? Schottky defect. So, always remember, Schottky and Frenkel refers to ionic compounds, and if Schottky is there, we just have to remember V, that means VS, we just remember VS, that means vacancy is there. Okay, now vacancy cannot be for one particular cation or one particular anion, it will be a pair. Therefore, electrical neutrality will be maintained. So, we will just learn the condition and the consequences, that time you will understand what is that. Conditions, now what are the conditions for the Schottky defect? That means high degree of ionic character should be there. High degree of ionic character should be there. Now, what do you mean by high degree of ionic character? That means the compound will generate ions very fast. That means if it is put in water or something like that, it will definitely create what? The charged species. We don't have to give external something like that. That's the reason we call it as what? High degree of ionic character. Simple. If we take an example of NaCl, NaCl when if we add in water, what will happen? It will dissociate into Na plus and Cl minus. Within no time, it will start dissociating into Na plus and Cl minus. Therefore, we call it as it is having what? High degree of ionic character. Okay. Next, high coordination number of the anion. Anion means negatively charged species. Anions are nothing but what? Negatively charged species. That means there will be having higher number of coordination number. Now, hope you know what do you mean by coordination number. The number of ions which is surrounded to it is nothing but the coordination number. Now, last condition for the formation Schottky effect is nothing but what? Small difference in the size of cation and anion. That means cation and anion will be almost of the same size. They will be almost of the same size. That means I can write it as R cation upon R anion will be almost equal to what? 1. That means not much difference will be there. Okay, understood? So, till here, it is about Schottky defect. Now, one more thing is there left out of Schottky defect. Consequences of Schottky defect. Nothing but we have to say about density and electrical neutrality. Now talking about density, you know that what will happen here? The density will decrease. So density here will decreases. Why decreases? As the mass decreases, volume is unchanged. Therefore, the density will decrease in Schottky defect. Okay, electrical neutrality is maintained over here. And some example. Electrical neutrality means, and hopefully you know what do you mean by electrical neutrality. That means if one positive species is taken out, one anionic species is also taken out. So that as a result, as a whole, the charge is neutral. The charge is zero over there. Okay, fine. Now, some examples over here. Some examples are nothing but NaCl, AgBr and KCl are some of the examples of what? Schottky defect. Okay. So hopefully till here it is understood. Okay. So one more is left in Schottky defect. This one stoichiometric defect. That is nothing but what? Frenkel defect. That we'll learn in the next class. Okay then. Thank you.